You know what? You know what? Having a selfie, you alright? Hello, I'm Cut from Cunt and the Gang. I'm just going to be playing some songs from my collection of minor internet hits and also some songs from your new album, Blue Ruffle. This is my last tour. I've been touring for 13 years, on and off. And the world's changed. Yeah, sorry about that. The world's changed a lot in the last 13 years since I started doing this. Please bear in mind, 13 years ago, Jimmy Savile, Rolf Harris and Stuart Hall were much-loved national treasures. 13 years. What?
Did you put it in? 13 years ago.
Really? Mm. What then? Anyone fiddling with you? Ben?
Ian Watkins.
Did he fiddle with you? He didn't, did he? I bet you were going, what's wrong with me? And of course, 13 years ago, the internet was kind of not like it is today. There was no Facebook, no Twitter, no YouTube. And so, Teabag, Seagull and Trombone were still nouns. This next one I'm going to do, something else that's been constant in the 13 years is nearly every venue I've visited, there has been an unflushed toilet there with a serious fucking movement in it. And normally the venues you go to, if you want a changing room, it's the cubicle or the gents' box. So you're fucking stood there in a kind of river of piss on one trainer, trying not to get a piss booty with little jobbies floating round you. Samurai Carey started off though, so you know what you're going to do. This is called Bangers and Mash. I was in the pub and I needed a piss. I went to the toilet so I could do this. But someone had stuffed some bog roll in the urinal, and someone else had had a piss there, and it was awful. So I thought to myself, that's no problem at all, I'll just relieve myself in the cubicle. Luckily there was no one in there doing a shite, but when I opened the door I saw a terrible sight. For fuck's sake, I only wanted a slash, but the bloke before me left bangers and mash. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash. The bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. Thought I'll let someone else find me bangers and mash. I tried to block it from my mind, but I was unable. I wore the toilet paper and a freshly laid cable. And it was fucking massive. Looked like Heather Mills' stump covered in fake tan. A little bit of sweet corn on the end, Ross. I gave it a flush, but it just wouldn't budge. The bog just filled up with water, toilet paper and fudge. There's a knock on the door, and I think in a flash, the next bloke's gonna think it's me that left the bangers and mash. Honestly, mate, I'll give you my word, that wasn't my bog roll, and that wasn't my turn. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash. The bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. Thought I'll let someone else enjoy me bangers and mash. Bangers and mash, bangers and mash. The bloke before me left bangers and mash. He could have flushed it away, but he didn't today. And now the next bloke thinks that I left the bangers and mash. Bangers and mash.
Thank you very much.
So this next one is about someone who I've been wanting to have a CD affair with since the mid-80s, since I was a teenage boy and I first got spunk in my ball bags. And this is called Carol Vorderman.
I'd like to put my willy in a noonie or a bum. She always gets the numbers right, she's got me into maths. I'll take away her pants and add my Corey to a gash.
Oh Carol, when I see you on countdown, I have to put my pants down and pop a finger in my brown.
When she multiplies, I unzip my flies. Then when she divides, I put my hand inside. And then when she adds, pop out my knob and nads. Then when she subtracts, I perform a sexual act. Carol's really glamorous, she wears the latest stuff. She fit for 40 something and I want to doink her up. She tells you the target, but it's my goal to a lady rider, flatten the square root of a hole. Oh Carol, when I see you on countdown, I have to pull my pants down and pop a finger in my brown. Oh Carol, when I see you on countdown, I have to pull my pants down and pop a finger in my brown. I've loved Carol Borden since 1985. I sometimes like to lurk around the bottom of her drive. I sometimes like to follow her when she goes to the shops. I sometimes open up her drains and examine her props. I met her once and told her that I was her biggest fan. She saw me an autograph and put it in my hand. But at the point I felt a little throbbing in my glands. I realised I was ejaculating in my pants. Save a Carol Borden, Carol Borden, Carol! Carol Borderman, Carol Borderman, Carol Borderman, Carol, Carol, Border, Border, Borderman.
Sorry, Ross, I lost control there, a bit like Michael Barrymore used to. Fancy a swim? It's Ross, it's real, sing Ross happy birthday, because it's Ross's birthday. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Ross. Happy birthday to you. Give him a round of applause, you old cunt. He don't want to make a big thing about it, though. So this next song, I'll move on, Ross, all right? I won't draw any more attention to you now. Now, Ross, this next song I'm going to do, a lot of people have said to me, can't you perfectly documented something that goes on every day on British building sites?
This was never the way I planned, not my intention. I was labouring on a building site, doing an extension. It's not what I'm used to. I just needed the cash in hand. I lost a bet with Dave the bricklayer, and as a forfeit I had to suck his gland. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it, the taste of his cheesy dipstick. I sucked off a bloke, can't deny it, I knew I should have took that job at Quickfit. It felt so wrong, now it seems strange the act, when everyone stood in a circle and clapped. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it, I didn't like it. And so the next day back on site, lots of bands to follow. How was I supposed to know? I didn't have to swallow. It's not what proper blokes do, not how they should behave. I can't show my face down the pub, since I noshed off that bricky Dave. I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it, the feel of his veiny fuck stick. I sucked off a bloke, can't deny it, cos someone Facebooked a photo of it. It felt so whack, it took so long, do you think that I was doing it wrong? I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it, I didn't like it. Us blokes, we don't do things by half, and on site they like to have a laugh. And sometimes someone gets sucked off, and someone films it on their mobile phone. Ain't no big deal, but don't show his wife,
she's bound to take it out of context.
I sucked off a bloke, I didn't like it, it didn't help, he had washed his helmet.
A such awkward bloke, how did I hear? It tasted like a bag of what's-its. It felt so wrong, it tasted so rank. I wish that I'd just give him a wank. A such awkward bloke, I didn't like it. I didn't like it. I fucking didn't. Thank you very much. Thank you. That was one from my new album, Blue Ruffle. And this next one is one from my 2014 album, Jap's iTunes. And this... Thank you. Or as it's called in Japan, iTunes. So... I had a Japanese man come up to me and tell me I'll put some Japanese writing on the cover, and he said to me, "Cunt, do you know that says Wee Hole songs? Google Translate, don't fucking trust it. Don't never trust it for a tattoo. You'll want like peace, love and happiness, and it'll be like chicken chow mein." So this next one I'm going to do for you, this is a song off Jap's iTunes, and this is a song about the kind of quieter, more reflective side of the entertainment industry and the kind of things that go on in a cheap hotel after a gig to kind of just to get you through the time. That's it, that's the lonely wanker. People think it's a glamorous life touring with your songs, but after the gig everyone goes home and the nights can seem so long. The pretty girls have all got boyfriends and they all go home to have it off, and I'm left alone in a chain hotel trying to imagine them having it off, but it's then there's no way I can dodge a lonely wank in a travel lodge. 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 So lonely, but a little bit sexy. I start to think of all the lonely salesmen who wanked here before me. They didn't want to pay 10 quid for Wi-Fi, so they just used their 3G. When I'm finished, I'll fill up the tiny little kettle and I'll make a cup of tea. The batteries are held in with electrical tape on the remote for the TV. Sometimes I do it in front of the mirror just to feel like there's someone else there. But all I see is my crying self wanking back at me in despair. The pretty girls have all gone home with all the handsome boys. I just spent 2 quid in the vending machine on a bag of steak McCoys. Now some juice from right outside this lot, via the medium of a lonely wank in a travel lodge. 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 Thank you very much. Now we've got one song left before the end of the first half, and but then we'll have a little break and we'll be back for the second half. Now I do want to warn anyone of a particularly sensitive nature, I've put all the nice songs in the first half and the second half is fucking horrible. In the half-time break, if anyone fancies, I've got some CDs there, a fiver a pop, including my new album, Blue Ruffle, and various other albums. I've got some T-shirts there, tenner a pop, my cunt Nike tick one, the top cunt one, and my Kentucky Fried Chicken one that says cunt, finger sniffing good since 2003. It works on a couple of levels. It's good for anyone that likes KFC, because I've nicked the logo, and it's good for anyone that doesn't like KFC, because I've nicked their logo, I'm not going to give them any money for it. Fuck the Colonel. So, no Colonel of me. So this, also there's some badges there, some really smashing badges. One for the vegetarians, corn is made from missing kids. You think they'd warn you, put Maddie on the packet or something. So, There's also one for the party goers, all back to Barrymore's. That's where we're going after, Ross, isn't it? Bit of fisting by the pool. So I'm going to leave you with this one. I'd like to welcome my new chum, Boise. Back up to the stage now. When I pack it all in, I'm going to try and sell Boise the Cunt franchise, all right? So Boise will be touring around playing my minor internet hits for me, and we're going to do a duet now of my first ever song, Use My Arse, I Was a Cunt. But I was too rude. I tried approaching companies, but they did not approve. Until I met this one guy, a corrupt A&R man. He said, cunt, I will sign you, but you have to understand. I want to utilise your bum as somewhere I can put my fingers and my hands, my toes and then my foot, my penis and testes, my tongue and then my head. I mould it over carefully, and this is what I said.
Go on then, just this once, use my arsehole as a gun. Use my arse, use my arse, use my arsehole, use my arse. Go on then, just this once, use my arsehole as a gun. Use my arse, use my arse, use my arsehole, use my arse.
Started feeling guilty, boys, see? I started feeling itchy around my bum hole. I started feeling achy around my underneath. I realised he'd used my bum without using a sheath. So I went to the doctors, because my bum was sore. I needed my bum sorted out, because me and Boise was due on tour. The doctor took a look at it. He said it looks quite raw. It looks itchy and flaky, but I just can't be sure. I'll need to use your bum myself if I'm to find a cure.
Go on then, just this once, use my arsehole as a gun. Use my arse, use my arse. Use my arsehole, use my arse, go on me. Just this one, use my arsehole as a cunt. Use my arse, use my arse, use my arsehole, use my arse.
Come on boys, so you know what to do. Penetrate me. Make me feel like Stephen Gately. It's quite gentle for a big man.
Or you'll end up with my shit around your brim.
Just this once, use my arsehole as a gun. Use my arse, use my arse, use my arsehole, use my arse. Go on then, just this once, use my arsehole as a gun. Use my arse, use my arse, use my arsehole, use my arsehole
as a cunt. Thank you.
Give it up for Boise! Right, go and get a beer, have a fag, ladies, stick in a tammy, slap on a sandy, and see you in 15 minutes. I'm just going to get a little friend of mine here. In case anyone's turned up here by mistake this afternoon, the reason I've got this small effigy of the world's worst paedophile ever is because he visited me in my dreams a couple of years ago. And then I woke up and he was actually there in the room, and he said to me, cunt, he said, I want you to write a song telling my side of the story. And I didn't want to do it, and I still don't fucking want to do it. I hate singing this song. It's a fucking horrible, hate-filled, terrible, horrible fucking song. But he keeps turning up in my bedroom and making me do it. And as you can imagine, in death as in life, he's very persistent. Just going to get on and play the song. It's only a minute and a half long. We can all get through it together. The other night, I
suddenly awoke to the spectral shape of this ghostly bloke. He was floating above me, just there in midair. He had a shell suit on and a mop of blonde hair. He said,
"Oh, it's Sir Jimmy, I return from the grave to attempt with your help my reputation to save."
He said,
now then, can you write me a song to explain what's happened with those girls in my dome?"
I said, "I'm not sure, I'd have to hear that explanation in case people think I'm a pedo by association." And this is what he told me. It was, "Sexy kids, sexy kids, made Jimmy Savile do what he did. Those kids were consenting, his shell suit bottoms were tenting with his feelings for the sexy kids."
Now then, how's about that then?
So Jimmy's ghost continued to maintain he'd done nothing wrong, and he tried to explain he had a cigar on his lips. And by that I don't mean that he was desperate to use a latrine. He said,
"All my good work will now be forgot because of my penchant for underage mops."
He said,
"Surely those marathons and charity races offset my spunking on teenagers' faces."
I said, "I'd write the song to get rid of his ghost," but then he told me one more time what bothered him most. It was, "Sexy kids, sexy kids, made Jimmy Savile do what he did. He got them in his rolls and fingered their holes, then gave charity a load of quids. Jimmy Savile and the sexy kids."
Marvellous, marvellous, just don't tell him, mother.
Thank you very much. That was not the most cheerful song, but luckily the next one is doubly cheerful, just to bring up the overall average. Now, this is a song that my granddad gave me when I was a little boy. He sat me on his knee and he said to me, "Cunt." He said, "I'm going to give you a word to use all through life for when something small goes wrong. And that word is fucksticks." So what I'd like to do here, I'd like to give you a bit of fucksticks and you all give me a bit of fucksticks back. Are we in? Right, let's give it a go. Fucksticks! Right, that was quite good, but that was more like a Colchester fucksticks. Don't you dare fucking boo me. You have a pull on a rubber glove and have a little look inside yourselves about that, alright? Let's give it another go. Let's do an Ipswich. Oh, well, yeah, well, you're probably to blame then. Well, you're Ipswich now, so let's dismember her, put her in a suitcase and sling her in a fucking lay-by, right? Now come on, I'm going to give you a bit of fucksticks, give me another bit of fucksticks back. Fucksticks!
Fucksticks!
Like that, he's more like it. That's more like it. Mr. Premature over there on the next bit. Ladies, don't let him near your bomb doors, he won't get it past the edge and it'll be... Right, so that is the next bit. My granddad gave me another phrase to use on that day for when something slightly worse than a fucksticks moment happens, and that is the phrase...
Mother's cunt!
Right, so what I want to do, I'll give you a bit of fucksticks and you all give me a bit of mother's come back, alright? Let's give it a go. Fucksticks!
Mother's
come! Fucksticks!
Mother's come!
Fucksticks!
Mother's
come! That's the kind of thing. Fucksticks!
Mother's come!
Fucksticks!
Mother's
come!
Fuck it. That's what happens when you have a joint mid-afternoon and there's a bit of a time delay. Right, okay, so I'm happy with that. I'm happy with the fucksticks and the mother's cunts. If you can use them in all the proper places in this next song, you can use them all the way through the next song. And this one's called Fucksticks. Now, my old granddad had a word he used when things went wrong. To introduce this word to you, I'll put it in a song. So every time this word gets used, his memory lives on. I'm about to tell you what it is, so you can sing along.
Fuck it,
and then wouldn't let him touch a furry pie.
Fuck it,
and he got some shrapnel lodged in his chap's eye.
Fuck it,
and a German sniper shot him in the cock.
Fuck it,
and he found a lump on his left bollock. And she left him all alone.
Fuck it.
When he let a bogus caller in his home.
Fuck it.
When the first black people moved into his street.
Fuck it.
When arthritis meant he couldn't beat his meat. Fucksticks, mother's cunt. Fucksticks. Right, I'm impressed with that song. I'd do my little cockney knees up that I'd do all on my own. Just like Chaz with a Dave's funeral.
time I hear the word, I start to reminisce. I suddenly taste Werther's and get a faint whiff of piss. So when someone annoys me or things get on my pip, I think of the moany racist old cunt and really let it rip.
Fuck it!
And I miss an open goal in five-a-side.
Fuck it!
And I lost my idols after Nana died.
Fuck it!
When the teachers told me that I was no good.
Fuck it!
And the old Bill called me wanking in the wood.
Fuck it!
When I'm having it off and I think of my old man.
Fuck it!
When little cunt skid marks down the pan.
Fuck it!
When some motherfucker pushes in a queue.
Fuck it!
When you get caught short and really need a poo. When I came a tumbling off my BMX. When I split my frenulum while having sex. And some smart ass bastard gives me my comeuppance. When it's ages since I've seen a lady's tuppence. When there's no clean pants you have to wear your mums. When Charlie won't let me fuck her up the bum. And you feel awkward and you don't know what to say. If you say fuck sticks, fuck sticks, fuck sticks, it makes everything okay. Fuck sticks, mother's cunt.
Fuck sticks!
Thank you very much. Top work. Oh, that's all right.
Easy.
I'll probably have to put a finger in each side to get any purchase. Topic's ruined it. So this next one I'm going to do now. Over the years I've been touring around the country, I've been asked one question more than any other question. This question's come back to haunt me. Every single tour go out, people ask me the same question. And that question is, cunt, what is it you find so attractive about your paper boy? Now, if I'd have known this song was going to be that popular, I'd never have fucking done it. So this is a song called Paperboy, and I'd like to dedicate it to my paperboy. Boy, so you're a paperboy. I'm going to tell you a little story about my paperboy. Paperboy. It's not a very happy one, won't bring you joy, but bring you joy, but bring you joy. My paper boy looks just like this girl who I used to fancy at school. I never plucked up the courage to ask her out, cause she was always a bit too cool. But now I'm older and more confident, I'm going to turn back the clock. By tricking my paper boy into my shed and introducing him to some soft pornography. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Paper boy, paper boy. I never thought that I would paper boy. Till he came along, now I'm singing this song about raping a paper boy. Paper boy, paper boy. I never thought that I would raper boy. Till he came along, now I'm singing this song about raping a paper boy. Local news on a Thursday afternoon. I hear him whistling down the path, but he won't be so cheerful soon. His family will be on the TV news putting out a tearful plea. But he isn't dead, he's trapped in my shed, crying and waiting for me. Dressed in a girl's school uniform. 1, 2, you gotta sing along now. Paper boy, paper boy. Singing this song about raping a paper boy. Everybody now, paper boy, paper boy. I never thought that I would rape a boy. Till he came along, now I'm singing this song about raping a paper boy. Of course, I haven't raped my paper boy. That's as twisted as you could get. I've restricted myself to having a wank watching him from behind my net. I know some blokes will hear this song and try and give me a fight. But last week he turned 16, so legally that's alright. 1, 2, at least I'm not a pedo. Paper boy, paper boy. I never thought that I would rape a boy. So
Well, he came along now, singing this song about raping a paper boy. One last time now, paper boy, of course I've never really raped a boy. I know that he's wrong, I'm just singing a song about raping a raping, till his arsehole's gaping, raping a paper boy.
Thank you very much. Now, I normally try and play a nice one after that to counterbalance it, but I haven't got any left, so that's another horrible one. Now, year before last, I got my girlfriend pregnant, and I went through a lot of conflicting emotions, and so I wanted to just write a song to kind of get all my feelings down on paper, and I did, and I'm going to play it for you now, and this is called The Abortion Song. I will say this song is fucking horrible. It's really, really horrible. It's an horrible, horrible song. But I've put it to a really cheerful melody, all right? So it makes it really nice. My girlfriend fell pregnant because we didn't take precautions. But she won't entertain the thought of having abortion. Look at me, I'm in no state for bringing up a kid. So what do I have to do to persuade her to get rid? Oh, do I run and hop off, chuck her down the stairs, stick a knitting needle up her when she's unawares, make her drink some gin, kick her in the crib, leave a load of marbles on the floor when I'm not in? I can't let this situation beat us. I've got to get rid of that fetus. That fetus. Now she knows I'm up to something, she's taking extra care. She's gone all paranoid and won't let me touch her down there. If I'm honest, I think I know what she's concerned about. Is I'll sneak a coat and her upper chuff and hook the fetus out. Or I could run and hop off, chuck her down the stairs, stick a knitting needle up her when she's unawares, smack her in the bum, keep making a jump, try and convince her it'll be when with a stump. I can't let this situation beat us. I've got to get rid of that fetus. I won't let this embryo defeat us. Of that fetus. Thank you very much. Thank you. Now, obviously, I don't mean that. I'm only mucking around. I just write all those songs to appear to be more of a bastard than I actually am, just so the women find it attractive. And this is a song all about that, and it's called Women Love a Bastard.
Girls all flocked around him just to see the skill he'd mastered. When asked him why girls liked him, he said, women love a bastard. So when I grew up, I must admit that once or twice I went out with girlfriends and I tried to treat them nice. Every time I did that, it just ended in disaster. Then I remembered Neil's advice that women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. I quicken up my pelvic thrust so I can climax faster. Then I have a fag and fall asleep because women love a bastard. So when I met my parent bird, I had to hatch a plan to attempt to be a bigger bastard of a man. She cooked a meal for Valentine's, I tried to play it cool. I took one mouthful, spat it out, then threw it up the wall. When she posts a Facebook status, I never once clicked like. On that cycle ride for charity, I pushed her off her bike. I left her in the hospital with a leg in plaster while I went round and fucked her mum, cause we're in love, a bastard, 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 we're in love, a bastard, 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 we're in love, a bastard. She broke down in church and ended up asking the pastor why I did it, he replied, cause we're in love, a bastard. I bought her a 99 from that ice cream place. Then when she went to take a lick, I smashed it in her face. She's got a nan with Alzheimer's who's not allowed out. I left her in her underwear on Bentley roundabout. Then when she did that fun run to raise money for the hospice, I went and got a toothbrush and I stuck it in some dog's mess. I rinsed it off with water before she went to bed. As she brushed her teeth, I texted her and this is what it said. Dog shit, you brushed your teeth with dog shit. Dog shit, you brushed your teeth with dog shit. I never come straight home from work, I stay out and get plastered. I do it just to turn her on, cause women love a bastard. I super glued her eyes open and I must concede, I made her watch the sequel to The Human Centipede. I took her away from all her friends and got her hooked on crack. Then I forced her to go on the game so she could pay me back. But it all backfired on me and she walked out today to go live in a refuge where abused women stay. So now I sit outside her window with a ghetto blaster and play Slipknot till 4 a.m. cause women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. Bastard, bastard, women love a bastard. If you ask me why I did it, all your query would be answered. I was only trying to make them worse cause women love a bastard. I was only trying to make them worse to get her finger blasted. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Now, sadly, we have come to the last song. Don't you dare boo this. It was free, you fucking cheapskate cunts. We've come to the... I do believe that. I do fucking believe that. I'm going to go home. My girlfriend's going to smell my fingers, isn't she? She'll think I've had a bag of scampi fries. Then she'll find the little croutons of fanny bat around my helmet and know that I've been unfaithful. So this one I'm going to leave you. We want to thank you all for coming out. Thank you to the people that come to see us for the first time tonight, but a special thanks to the repeat offenders that have come back time and time again. When I played at the Royal Open then here and wherever I played in Ipswich. So, and special thanks, can we have a round of applause for Boys C? Because what you don't know was there was no fucking PA here because the punk band, one of the band's dads split his head open, so they fucked off and took their PA with them, so there was going to be no gig, but Boise went all the way back home and got his PA. He went all the way back home across the road and got his PA for us, bless him. Don't fucking milk it. So again, if you find yourself with a fiver burning hole in your pocket, please do consider buying one of my CDs. When my tour's open, I've still probably got 8,000 moulding doors open around my mum's. CDs are fiver and t-shirts are 10. If anyone wants a selfie, come and see us. But listen, if you want a selfie and you ask me for a selfie, that means you take the photo yourself. So okay, people come out all the time and go, come, can I have a selfie? Then they give the phone to their mate. And you're like, it's not a selfie, is it? It's a someone else-y. Or as I like to call it, a normal fucking photo. So just know what you're asking for. So I'm going to leave you with this one now. Up here, save me fucking sitting back down and getting back up again. I'll do one more for you now.
Two more!
Can I just... Don't fucking push your luck. Can I just check... who voted to leave? Give me a cheer. Who voted to leave? Right, I've done a big argument about it. Who voted to remain? See, I voted to leave, but I thought it meant leave things as they are. So these are the cunts that started all that fucking business off, and this is called That's Why I'm Voting UKIP. goes from side to side, not back to front. And did you know in Jamaica, ladies have a cloaca? That means a bum and fanny all in one. Did you know in Paraguay, they stretch girls furry pie and insert a big ceramic cup? And did you know in Senegal, birds have got no quim at all? They cut their clip box off and sew it up. The thing I really fear is what if they come over here, all them foreign fannies in our own backyard. I'm gonna go in my garage with a picture of Nigel Farage and make myself a big purple placard. Cos that's why I'm voting UKIP. Don't think me unhinged. That's why I'm voting UKIP to save the British minge. That's why I'm voting UKIP. My message is succinct. Don't let the great British minge become extinct. Don't let the great British minge become extinct. God save our gracious minge. Long live our noble minge. Nigel, help us save the British minge. Send it victorious, hairy and glorious. Nigel, help us save the British minge. Did you know in Saudi Arabia, no one's seen the ladies' labia, cos they have to do their business in the dark. And in Papua New Guinea, did you know a lady's mini has got a set of teeth just like a shark? And did you know that in Iraq, a lady's crack emits a bit of discharge like crude oil? And did you know in Bulgaria, ladies' fannies are hairier than anywhere in the world except Susan Boyle? The main parties don't go far enough to protect the British muff. The only way to stop it is to vote. I considered the BNP, but they're too far right for me. They want to put Thatcher's fuck flaps on the banknote. That's why I'm voting UKIP. Don't think me unhinged. That's why I'm voting UKIP to save the British minge. That's why I'm voting UKIP. Come on, join the hunt. You gotta love Nigel Farage, cos he's a proper British cunt. Thank you very much. That's a fucking lot. Thank you very much. I'll see you later.